The tale you are about to hear may come off a bit queer. I am glad to tell you what I can. Mind you, I'm an ignorant man. At my beginning, I must beseech. I may use improper speech. I'm not one who usually knows what to say. I'm sure I'll succeed along the way. I may not allow the beauty to appear, but if you wish,
the story shall hear.
Once upon a time, on the island of Brittany, a young soldier by the name of Joe was infatuated with a young girl named Sarah. Joe could not help but notice her out of all the girls on the island. Joe was determined to do everything he could to get Sarah's attention.
You stuck a mate in my laughing eyes. I can't pretend though I try to hide. I like you. I like you. I think I felt my heart skip a beat. I'm standing here and I can hardly breathe. You got me, yeah, you got me. The way you take my hand is just so sweet. And that crooked smile of yours, it knocks me off my feet.
Love him.
Oh, that is so cute. I want you to take it to the next level. I'm really happy.
I know. Well, we'll see where this goes.
Sarah Doreen Borkham, will you take me as a lovely
part of place? Yes! You're mine!
Joe was thrilled that Sarah agreed to marry him. They got married and made eternal vows to each other.
I promise to never be jealous or controlling of what you do.
I promise to be a loving and faithful wife.
Do you take this woman to be your lawfully wedded wife?
I do.
Do you take this man to be your lawfully wedded husband?
I do.
I now pronounce you husband and wife.
Joe and Sarah lived in perfect harmony together for nearly a year.
Today and every day.
Joe was called to fight in a war overseas to serve the country.
Sarah, I got a call today. I've been called to serve our country. I'll be gone for a year. Please don't forget.
As the days increased from Joe's departure, Sarah's depression grew more and more. Sarah was afraid that her husband's ship would be smashed against the rocks along the coast of Brittany and that he would drown and never return. Sarah's friends tried to distract her from this fear and provide her solace by taking her to a party.
Hey, Amber, you know, I don't like the way you've been.
to not miserable. Just come check out this party with me.
Maybe it's for a little, I guess. Let's go.
Turn up the lights in here, baby. Extra bright.
But it did not do any good because Sarah was still depressed. A swagtastic fella named James noticed Sarah's miserable state. James had always secretly loved Sarah for years. He felt this was his chance to confess his love to her, although she was married.
She loved the way I'm doing it. So good she won't put my tattoo on it. Bottom line is, you the finest. Gave you a new name. What's that? Hold up.
Whoa there.
Let's capture this moment. If I then I own it. Wanting every moaning. On the throne and girl we groaning. But that got me feeling like a kid with a streetlights on.
The garnished James solicitously felt for Sarah. This was his chance to tell her, but Sarah had one condition and was confident he couldn't achieve it.
Hey, yo, Petey, what you doing out here?
Man, I don't want to be here. Some new joke.
Why?
I'm right here.
Keep saying that game.
What game?
This is the truth.
I love you. I can provide for you. I can make you happy because obviously you're not. And the only way we'll ever be together is if you remove those rocks.
It'll never happen.
Said I want you exactly like I used to. And baby, this is all be bringing me down. She said I want you.
Time had passed, and finally, Joe was home without crashing into a single rock. James was forgotten by Sarah, but he was still so miserable. Finally, he confided in his brother.
Homie, what you doing in here?
Get up.
Why?
Get up.
I can't stop thinking about it.
Can't stop thinking about who?
Sarah, I love her.
Whoa, hold up. There's this girl, Ari. She's been trying to get at you. She's a little cutie.
Ari? The one with the booty?
Yeah.
Nah, bro. I want Sarah. Sarah has the booty. She has everything. I love her.
Then get her.
I can't.
Why not?
It's impossible.
Impossible is nothing.
She wants me to move all the rocks off the Brittany coast. We both know that can't be done.
Hold up. I got this friend, right? She's kind of whack, but I know she can help you win Sarah.
Win Sarah?
Win Sarah.
I want to win Sarah.
Win Sarah.
Let's win Sarah.
Win Sarah.
Go. Win Sarah.
James, are we almost here? Hold up. I thought you said this was your friend, James.
Holy shit.
Wow. Let's go.
James meets Jason's friend, Lady Morticia.
Onward, onward, onward!
My brother James, he needs some help because he has some problems right now.
What's the problem for you?
Well, I'm in love with this lady, but she's married. The only way we can be together is if I remove all the rocks off of Brittany coast, and I'm desperate.
All right, let me bring you to my lair and we'll figure something out.
My lair.
There's one thing you need to do so that this will work. Put your arms over there. Okay, what is this girl's name?
Sarah.
And you have to remove all the rocks from the pretty coast just to be with her?
That's right.
How many times did it rain this year, do you think?
I don't know, about 5. That's just my opinion.
That's all we need. It's gonna take me a few days to figure this out, but it's all we need. I know I can do this.
Thanks. You're really helping me out. I love her, man.
Thanks, man. I'll pay you anything.
Don't worry about it. Just give me a few days.
Lady Morticia devises a way to move the rocks.
Is this even gonna work? This is a joke.
Trust me.
All the rocks from the Britney Coast.
What?
It's true.
Shoot!
Let go!
Woo! Yeah! Let's go!
Rushes to tell Sarah of the news.
Sarah! I found a way! I got the rocks out of the ocean! We can be together!
Must now tell Joe the devastating promise she made to James.
When you're gone, I made a promise with James. I told him that if he removed all the rocks from the Brittany coast, I'd be with him. I thought it was impossible, but he made it happen, and I don't know what to do.
You know what? You made a promise.
No!
Go be with
him. No, but I want to be with you. I love you.
It's okay. Just keep your honor.
No!
Keep your honor. I'll always love you. Just keep your honor.
James realizes that the only reason why Sarah's with him is because Joe told her so.
So, I've noticed that you're not happy with me, and all I really want for you is happiness. I love you, but I guess that's just not enough. I want you to go back to him. Thank you.
It's not a silly little moment. It's not the storm before the calm. This is the deep and dying breath of this love that we've been working on.
Sarah runs to tell Joe that true love prevails.
Sarah, James realized our true love and how the way we're for letting me go. So we can be together now.
We can be together again?
Yes, yes, we can be together.
I love you.
You could call me your baby girl. Maybe we could spend some time.
James must now face the debt he has to pay to Lady Morticia.
Lady Morticia, are you here?
Over here!
Lady Morticia, James. It didn't work out with Sarah. She went back to Joe. And first Joe let her come back to me, but she wasn't happy. So I respect that, and I just want to let true love happen. I'm really sorry, but I don't have the money. I'm thankful, but there's no way I can pay you for what you did.
James, Joe was a noble man for allowing Amber to be with you, but you are even a greater noble man for realizing that true love needed to happen between them. The debt that you have to pay with me is gone. You have no debt on your shoulders, my friend. Go and live a happy life and find true love for yourself. Thank you.
As time went on, Sarah and Joe created a family. They lived happily ever after. This story was told to show that judgment and justice are essential keys in life.
This will be an everlasting love. This will be the one I've waited for. This will be the first time anyone has loved me. Oh, I'm so glad he found me.
Santa Claus is coming to town.
Hey.
Come tell me what you want for Christmas.
Come.
Do like a ooh.